Hi, this is Johnny. I'm a global artist ambassador for Phoenix 360, and I'm blessed to be joined today by the guitarist Timmy Schools. Timmy, what's up? How are you?
Hey, what's up, John?
All right, dude. Good to see you, man. Hey, listen, I'm looking forward to sharing some of your music with our audience. So is it okay if we tune into your YouTube channel and check out some of your guitar work?
Yeah, definitely.
All right, great. All right, let's tune in now to Timmy Schools from his YouTube channel, Ripping the Guitar. Timmy, great work, man. And just love to see that dexterity on that fretboard. Hey, listen, tell me, man, where are you from and how'd you get involved in starting to play guitar?
I'm from California. I grew up there and I always did love music. Cheap Trick was a really early influence of mine on the guitar, their Live at Budokan album.
I
ended up getting really into the Beatles about freshman year of high school. I actually started a club at my high school called the Classic Rock Appreciation Club. And I was in the newspaper and we would listen to classic rock. We would debate, like, is John better, is Paul better? And I got into Eddie Van Halen and, like, kind of what you would call like hair metal, right? And I got into this band and we would play shows at high school. We would play, like, you know, we'd play Metallica songs, Iron Maiden, Van Halen. Cool. It was really great. It was some of the best experiences of my life, for sure.
I tell you what, Timmy, that is so cool that you were brought up on those rock and roll legends. And then actually we're able to emulate, you know, their sounds and you know, moves. And it's just so incredible. I loved all those artists you talked about, you know what I mean? And I've been to-
We tried to emulate some of the moves while we'd be on the stage. I did smash a bass one time. I was emulating the Who. We had an old drum set and an old bass that were pretty garbage. So we smashed them up and we used to crowd surf. It was pretty cool. It really was.
Very cool. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And
you know, they're the glory of all that, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. To engage with fans in that way, like you say, crowd surf and smashing guitars. That's so much energy and fun. And that's what a lot of the rock and roll imagery kind of portrayed over the years. Think about Keith Moon in The Who and what he would do to his drum sets and on and on. And I love talking about the rock icons and even some of the hair bands you talked about, you know what I mean? I've been to a number of Maiden concerts and over the days, and I just really love it. So I appreciate
it. There's a tragic side to this too, that has to be said though, which is the effect that the computer has had on this kind of thing. Like, these concerts don't really happen anymore, and it's sad. And there's other reasons for that too. But, you know, it's after high school, after this band, I noticed kind of a tragic decline in interest in the guitar, and it has become like a novelty. It used to be, like, I was actually watching Led Zeppelin the other night, Song Remains the Same, and Jimmy Page, like, he's like a god up there, you know? And it's like, the ethics of that are debatable, but we just don't seem to have that anymore. Like, he took this art to such a high level. It's like a Michelangelo sculpture, you know, and people like Eddie Van Halen, like, it feels like it's all mass produced on a computer now, and nobody likes anything unless it has a big 808 kick drum and a really simple synthesizer beat and these hi-hats that take the whole thing and really like vocals that are really just domineering, overproduced.
You know, and listen, I understand that. And I know that the digital transformation that we've all had to endure, you know, has really changed things a lot. And we have to navigate, you know, even think about the pandemic in the last couple of years. It's really kind of quelled all live music has been really, you know, difficult on the industry and all those artists. And and I'm glad that, you know, ultimately, put it this way, the things happen like in a wave, you know what I mean? So there's lulls and then there's the wave builds and it gets crescendo and then crashes. I mean, the fact of the matter is these things come in cycles.
And cycles, so, you're right. Yeah.
So I believe that there's going to be a resurgence in the interest, and especially in these old bands from the 70s and so forth, that, you know, that the guitar was ultimately the, you know, the driving force of all this music and interest. And so at any rate, I believe it will make its way back. And I've always been a devout fan. And of course, you know, came in that era that you're talking about. And when all these kinds of icons like Eddie Van Halen were literally godlike status. And many of my other artist friends who, you know, had inspirations from Michael Jackson and in the pop, there's all kinds of pop stars that, you know, have the same kind of attraction to those fans for that genre and that amazing icon. So it's almost on the same thing for Eddie Van Halen and Michael Jackson, even, you know, two different genres, but there's the, like I said, they have almost a following and a power that's just so magnetic that that's huge fan bases around the world. Anyway, you're guitaring, bro. You know, the fact of the matter is you still kept engaged in it.
Well, when I recognized this change about 10 years ago, I did start working on the laptop, and I have Ableton Live, I have Massive, I have Native Instruments Contact, I have FM8. I do like Skrillex, and what I want to see is one thing that's on my YouTube channel is Korn and Skrillex doing a song together. I think it's really cool mixing dubstep and guitar, and I try to do that on the laptop, and it's hard. It is really a hard thing to combine together, to master together, but I think it sounds great when it works.
Yeah, and listen, the combination also of video content that complements your music, you know what I mean, is also artwork. And so music videos are becoming more, you know, interesting, dynamic, and popular, I think, again. And so yeah, there's an opportunity there, where, you know, you can actually create and become a more dynamic artist by these other kinds of influences that you mix along with your music. So at any rate, you know, you got a pretty bad organ behind you. What's the story on that?
So this organ, I actually got this for free off of Craigslist. This organ is from 1980. It sold for $11,000 in 1980. All right. I have the original receipt right in the organ bench over there. My amp's on top of the organ bench. This is a Lowry.
Cool, man.
And I've opened it up one time. It's basically a spaceship in there. So if you adjust for inflation, this thing's worth about $30,000.
That thing looks like a time machine.
Okay. I also have a pipe organ in the room back there. This one's over 100 years old. It's a SD pipe organ. It's also worth tens of thousands adjusted for inflation. It was a really nice organ, but I got it for $70 at Goodwill. The crazy thing is these things, this is part of what I'm saying, it's tragic. These things are not valued anymore. Like, I can show you the receipt, all these music books, they're all marked up. This person loved this organ. Right. They loved it so much. Oh. They probably had it their whole life, you know, and then they went to the retirement home and their sons or daughters were selling the house. So they had the organ on Craigslist. It was the last day. They were just going to throw it out. And
I mean, for some, you know, some man's trash is another man's treasure.
Yeah, so, like, they just don't make definitely stuff have like soul anymore. You got a lot of soul.
But at any rate, bro, let me hear some of that guitar, man. Maybe you can just give me a couple of riffs.
Okay.
Yes,
something like that.
You don't see that at the concerts anymore either. You see everybody's phone light.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
That's why I had to do that. But at any rate, Jimmy, man, it's so cool to visit with you. I love talking shop and guitar. Man, you keep your art rolling. I think what we're going to do is we're going to follow your progress, bro, as you drop music and art. And we're going to tune into your social media channels, which you find below our interview today. And we're also
I predict we'll see a renaissance of electronic music and guitar coming together in the coming decades. So I agree with what you're saying.
We'll be a pioneer for that. And we're also going to look forward to having you up on Phoenix 360. So thank you for joining me today, brother.
Of course. Thank you.
Thanks, man.
Yeah. It was really fun. Thank you.
Likewise, bro. Take care.